हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्स प्रतिभा सोनोने, फैकल्टी फ्रॉम श्री जैन विद्या प्रसारक मंडल्स, रसिकलाल एम धारेवाल कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मसी, चिंचवड, पुणे. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इव्हॅल्युएशन ऑफ क्रूड ड्रग्स, विच इज वन ऑफ द चैप्टर फॉर फर्स्ट इयर डी फार्मसी स्टूडेंट्स फ्रॉम फार्माकोग्नोसिस सब्जेक्ट. दिस इज अ सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ दिस व्हिडिओ. In first video, we have already discussed about evaluation of crude drugs and different methods of evaluation with organoleptic evaluation and microscopical evaluation of the crude drugs. In today's video, you will be able to understand chemical evaluation, physical evaluation and biological evaluation. First, we will discuss chemical method of evaluation. Chemical method of evaluation, as its name suggests, it consists of chemical test and isolation, purification and identification of the active chemical constituents from the crude drug. This method consists of different tests such as acid value, saponification value, iodine value, ester and acetyl value, and determination of methoxy groups. Acid value can be used for the evaluation of resins, saponification, and iodine value can be used for balsams. Ester and acetyl values can be used for volatile oils. In chemical evaluation, different methods are there for evaluation of the crude drugs, such as titration, gravimetric analysis, chromatographic analysis, spectrometric analysis is there. The preliminary phytochemical screening is a qualitative chemical evaluation which indicates spectrum of chemical constituents present in a plant. The successive solvent extraction of crude drug is carried out with different solvents such as petroleum ether, benzene, solvent ether, chloroform, ethanol and water in succession. The conventional titrimetric estimations as applicable to estimation of alkaloids from the crude drugs, ester and aldehyde contents of volatile oils, gravimetric methods are used. So, such methods are used in the techniques of chemical assays. The chemical tests are also helped in proper identification of varieties of crude drugs. For example, Van Neuk test is used for ergot. Halfen's test is used for RHS oil. Bontager test is used for anthraquinone glycosides. For example, the solutions of lead acetate or lead subacetate are used specifically for chemical entities of gums. The alkaloid containing drugs such as Ralphia, Belladonna, Ergot, Ipecacuanha and glycosides bearing drugs like Senna, Digitalis, Squill, Stophanthus can be identified with the help of specific chemical test. The different classes of natural products present as active constituents in crude drugs can be identified by performing several general and specific chemical tests. As I already told you that Halfen's test is used for cottonseed oil or RHS oil. Van Neuk's reagent can be used for ergot. Vitalis test is used for propane alkaloids, and for alkaloids, Brontager test is used for anthraquinone alkaloids, and Murex test is used for purine bases. These are the examples of chemical test. Another example is that starch grains gives blue color with the iodine. So here you can use iodine as staining agent and you can find out the whether the drug contains starch or not, as it forms a thick viscous solution on boiling with the water. The estimation of chief constituents or a group of active constituents is an integral part of chemical evaluation, such as total senocytes in senna, morphine in opium, citral in lemongrass oil, eugenol in clove oil, water soluble alkaloids in ergot, propane alkaloids in belladonna, reserpine in ralphia. The chemical test also helps in proper identification of varieties of the crude drugs. The solution of lead acetate and subacetate are used specifically for identification of the gums. नेक्स्ट मेथड फॉर द इवेल्युएशन ऑफ द क्रूड ड्रग इज फिजिकल मेथड ऑफ इवेल्युएशन. इन फिजिकल मेथड ऑफ इवेल्युएशन वी हैव डिफरेंट फिजिकल कॉन्स्टेंट्स विच आर यूज फॉर द डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ द ड्रग्स. दे मे हेल्प इन इवेल्युएशन स्पेसिफिकली विथ रेफरेंस टू स्पेसिफिक ग्रेविटी डेंसिटी ऑप्टिकल रोटेशन स्पेसिफिक रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स मेल्टिंग पॉइंट विस्कोसिटी सोल्युबिलिटी इन सॉल्वेंट्स एंड सम आर डिस्क्राइब हियर. इन दैट फर्स्ट इज द डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ मॉइस्चर कंटेंट, सेकंड डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ विस्कोसिटी, डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ मेल्टिंग पॉइंट, डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ ऑप्टिकल रोटेशन, डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स, डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ ऐश कंटेंट, डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ एक्सट्रैक्टिव वैल्यूज एंड डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ वोलेटाइल ऑयल कंटेंट. सो हियर वी विल डिस्कस वन बाय वन. फर्स्ट इज मॉइस्चर कंटेंट. द परसेंटेज ऑफ एक्टिव केमिकल कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स इन द क्रूड ड्रग्स इज मेंशन ऑन एयर ड्राइड बेसिस. दैट मीन्स द ड्रग शुड नॉट कंटेन मॉइस्चर more than the limit. If moisture is present in the crude drug more than the limit, that time it may lead to the degradation of the chemical agents. Here the moisture content of a drug should be determined and should be controlled. The moisture content of a drug should be minimized in order to prevent decomposition of crude drugs either due to chemical change or microbial contamination. It is determined by heating a drug at 105 degrees Celsius in an oven to a constant weight. For example, aloes, it contains not more than 10% weight by weight of the moisture. Digitalis, 5%, ergot, 8%, acacia, 15%, and starch contains not more than 15% of moisture content. Next is viscosity. Viscosity of a liquid is constant at a given temperature and is an index of its composition. Hence, it can be used as a means of standardizing liquid drugs. Mostly viscosity is used for the liquid drugs. For example, liquid paraffin is having kinematic viscosity not less than 64 centistokes. And pyroxylene is having kinematic viscosity 1100 to 2450 centistokes. The viscosity is measured in stokes. One stoke is equal to 100 centistokes. Third physical method is determination of melting point. It is one of the parameter to judge the purity of the crude drugs. In case of pure chemicals or phytochemicals, melting point is very very sharp and constant. Since the crude drugs from animal or plant origin contains mixed chemicals, they are described with certain range of melting point. For example, colophony 75 to 85, kokum butter 39 to 42, then coca butter 30 to 33, beeswax 62 to 65, anhydrous wool fat 34 to 40, hard paraffin 52 to 57. Fourth physical factor is optical rotation. Certain substances has property of rotating the plane of polarized light in pure state or in the solution is an optically active substance. The phenomena is known as optical rotation. If plane of polarized light is rotated towards the left, it is called as levorotatory, and if it is rotated towards the right, it is called as dextrorotatory. The optical rotation is determined at 25 degrees Celsius using polarimeter. For example, clove oil is having 0 to minus 1.5 degree, honey plus 3 to minus 15, caraway plus 70 to plus 18 degree, and castor oil not less than plus 3.5 degree. रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स, व्हेन अ रे ऑफ लाइट पासेस फ्रॉम वन मीडियम टू अनदर मीडियम ऑफ डिफरेंट डेंसिटी इट बेंड्स द लाइट फ्रॉम इट्स ओरिजिनल पाथ. रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स इज टर्म एज द रेशियो ऑफ वेलोसिटी ऑफ लाइट इन वैक्यूम टू द वेलोसिटी ऑफ लाइट इन अ मीडियम. रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स वैरीज विद द वेवलेंथ ऑफ द लाइट. इट इज डिटरमाइंड बाय यूजिंग सोडियम वेपर लैम्प एंड डिटरमाइंड एट 25 डिग्री सेल्सियस. वी कैन यूज रिफ्रैक्टोमीटर फॉर द डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स. डिपेंडिंग ऑन प्यूरिटी इट इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट फॉर अ लिक्विड एंड कैन बी कंसिडर वन ऑफ द क्राइटेरिया फॉर ए स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन. रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ कंपाउंड वैरीज विद द वेवलेंथ ऑफ इंसिडेंट लाइट, टेम्परेचर एंड प्रेशर. रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्सेस ऑफ सम कंपाउंड्स आर फॉर सोडियम लाइट एंड एट अ टेम्परेचर 25 डिग्री सेल्सियस विल बी मेजर्ड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल क्लो ऑयल इट इज हैविंग रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ 1.5300 to 1.5310. Castor oil is having 1.4758 to 1.4798. Caraway oil is having 1.4838 to 1.4858 as a refractive index. Next most important factor, physical factor for the crude drugs is ash content or ash volume. As mentioned earlier, evaluation of a drug basically needs its identification and can be done by morphological or microscopical characters. But many times the drug identified by its diagnostic characters is of substandard quality due to either faulty collection or incorrect storage. Thus, to prove its acceptability as a drug, some test can be applied to it whenever possible, such as ash content, extractive values and volatile oil contents. We will discuss first about the ash content. Ash content, it is the residue remaining after incineration is called as a ash content of a drug, which simply represents the inorganic salts naturally occurring in drug or adhering to it or deliberately added to it as a form of adulteration. Therefore, it is a criteria to judge the identity or purity of the crude drug. Total ash usually consists of carbonates, phosphates, silicates and silica. For example, aloe is having 5% weight by weight. Then cannabis 15% weight by weight and ginger total ash is 6% weight by weight. So ash content is very much important criteria to judge the identity and purity of the crude drug. It indicates to some extent the care taken in the collection and preparation of the drug, and it is used to determine quantitatively inorganic salts present in the crude drug. Ash contents are having different types such as total ash, acid insoluble ash, water soluble ash and sulfated ash. So first is the total ash. Total ash of the drug is inclusive of physiological ash as well as non-physiological ash. Physiological ash is derived from the plant tissues, while non-physiological ash consists of residues of the extraneous matter such as sand, soil, etc. adhering to the herb itself. Thus, it consists of carbonates, phosphates and silicates. Second type is acid insoluble ash. It is the part of total ash which is insoluble in dilute hydrochloric acid. So first you have to calculate the total ash, you have to incinerate the to calculate the total ash, and then that total ash will be used for the identification of the or evaluation of the acid insoluble ash with dilute hydrochloric acid. For example, cannabis, it is having not more than 5% weight by weight acid insoluble ash. Cardamom, not more than 3.5% and agar not more than 1% weight by weight acid insoluble ash. Third type of ash is water soluble ash. It is used to detect the presence of material exhausted by the water. It helps to detect the presence of exhausted material in the genuine drug. It is calculated by dissolving total ash in 25 ml of water for 5 minutes. Fourth type is sulfated ash volume. It is calculated by incinerating the powder duct at a temperature of about 600 degrees Celsius with dilute sulfuric acid before ignition. Due to this process, all the oxides and carbonate are converted to the sulfated salts. Second factor or second evaluation for the crude duct is determination of extractive values. Extractive value is the criteria to determine quality and quantity both for the crude duct. The extracts obtained by exhausting crude ducts are indicative of approximate measure of certain chemical constituents they contain. Taking into consideration the diversity of chemical nature and properties of the contents of the drugs, various solvents are used for the determination of the extractives. Because different chemicals are soluble in different solvents, the solvent used for extraction is in a position to dissolve appreciable quantities of the substances desired. The solvent is evaporated and weight of extractive is determined. In extractives, there are three types. First one, water soluble extractive value. Second, ether soluble extractive value. And third, alcohol soluble extractive value. First, we will discuss water soluble extractive value. Water is a good solvent used for sugar, mucilage, plant acids. It is used for those drugs which contains above chemicals. For example, aloe, it contains should not contain not be less than 25%. Then senna, not less than 30%, and ginger, not less than 10% of the water soluble extractive. Next is alcohol soluble extractive. Alcohol is a good solvent for the resins and tannins. Alcohol is an ideal solvent for extraction of various chemicals, as most of the chemicals are soluble in alcohol. Therefore, this method is frequently used for the determination of approximate resin content, tannin contents, etc. It is also an official method for assay in case of myrrh and asafoetida. Generally, 95% ethyl alcohol is used for determination of alcohol soluble extractive. In some cases, dilute alcohol may be also used depending upon the solubility of the constituents in the crude drug. For example, asafoetida in 90% alcohol contains not less than 50% of the alcohol soluble extractives. Ginger, not less than 4.5%, and benzoin, not less than 90% for Siam benzoin and not less than 75% for Sumatra benzoin. Then ether soluble extractives. Volatile ether soluble extract value. Ether soluble extractives, they are divided into two classes or two types. First one is the volatile ether soluble extractive value and second non-volatile ether soluble extractive. Volatile ether soluble extractive value represents volatile oil content of the crude duct, and non-volatile ether soluble extractive value, it represents fixed oil and present in coloring matters of the crude ducts. For example, capsicum contains not more than 12% of weight by weight. Then nutmeg, not more than 25% weight by weight, and linseed, not more than 25% weight by weight of the ether soluble extractive values. In case of alcohol soluble extractive values, you can also calculate alcohol insoluble extractives. Alcohol insoluble extractive values are applicable to some resinous drug such as myrrh, which contains not more than 70% alcohol insoluble extractives, and benzoin, not more than 24% alcohol insoluble extractives. Volatile oil content. Efficacy of several crude drugs is due to their odorous principles, which is also called as volatile oils. Such crude drugs are standardized on the basis of their volatile oil contents. Percentage of volatile oil can be calculated by Quetzal distillation method or toluene distillation method. For example, phenyl contains 1.4% of weight by weight, not less than 1.4% weight by weight, and cardamom not less than 4%, and caraway not more less than 2.5% weight by weight. In volatile oil content evaluation, we can use different chromatographic techniques such as thin layer chromatography, high performance lithography, which is also called as HSC, gas chromatography, which is also called as GC, column chromatography, gel permeation chromatography, affinity chromatography, as well as techniques like spectrophotometric methods, radio immunoassays are used very frequently for the physical evaluation of the crude drugs. Last evaluation method is biological evaluation. Biological evaluation includes biological assays as performed for those drugs which cannot be tested properly in laboratories. When the estimation of potency of crude drugs or its preparation is done by means of its effect on living organisms like bacteria, fungi, fungal growth, or animal tissues or entire animal, it is known as bioassay. This method is generally called for when standardization is not adequately done by chemical or physical means. In other words, bioassay is the measure of sample being tested capable of producing the biological effect as that of the standard preparation. Such an activity is represented in units known as international unit, that is IU. The specific biological activity contained in each IU or international unit of few drugs is given here. Digitalis contains 1 IU is contains 76 mg of standard preparation. Vitamin A, also 1 unit, is contained in 0.344 micrograms of standard preparation. Vitamin D, same 1, is contained in 0.025 micrograms of standard preparations. Biological assay methods are mainly of 3 types: toxic, symptomatic, and tissue methods. In toxic and symptomatic techniques, the animals are used, whereas in tissue method, the effect of the drug is observed on isolated organ or tissues. Among the drugs that are subjected to bioassay are cardiac glycosides, vitamins, hormones, saponins, anthracycline glycosides, and antibiotics, which are assayed by microbiological assays. I hope all of you have properly understood what do you mean by evaluation of the crude drug, different methods of evaluation of the crude drugs. Thank you.